Let's talk about deploying your backend to Vercel. So Vercel is a front-end cloud, which means that we integrate with all of the popular front-end frameworks like Next.js or Nuxt or SvelteKit, but that doesn't mean that we don't support running backend code. Some of these front-end frameworks work across the client and the server, so you're able to have API routes or you're able to server render pages. But when we talk about backends or traditional backends, usually we think of something that's maybe just an API or something that's talking to a database, and you can also run those workloads on Vercel. So let's take a look. We have a handful of templates that you can get started from. The one I'm going to show today is just a simple Node.js-based function for your backend. We also have a template for Fastify and some other backend tools. You can also use something like Express if you wanted to. But in general, you're thinking about the way you write your backend just a little bit differently on Vercel. And I'm going to show exactly what this looks like. So I'm going to hit deploy from here. And inside of my Git repository, which we've already connected to, it's going to create this new repository here, Node.js Serverless Function Express. We're going to make this private. It's going to deploy to my account. And what this is going to do is make a new API endpoint for my application. So it's going to download this code. It's going to kick off this build and then upload that new API endpoint to a unique URL that I'm going to get and be able to access over the internet. Now, this is using Node.js, so I can use all the latest Node.js features. I can talk to my database. I can connect to external services. I can run some potentially long jobs up to 5 minutes on Pro. I can stream something back from my AI provider. All of that is possible here. So now if I click out into my new URL and I go to /API/hello, we see our brand new Node.js function. Now, this is just a backend API. We could talk to our database here. We could return back some JSON, some XML, some text files. We can really do whatever we want here. Now, typically with a lot of these backend JavaScript frameworks, like Express, for example, you can define a bunch of different routes in your application in this one file. So /API or /API some parameterized slug. I think Fastify is, you know, kind of also similar like this. You can absolutely still use some of these backend frameworks in this way by essentially rewriting requests from this incoming route to this file that we've created here inside of our API folder, which is part of that example that we cloned. But you can also do it in a way where you have different files for each different API. So I have API/hello, I have API/user. You can just drop those files in a folder and they'll work with Vercel, whether you want to use a framework or you want to do something separately. And once you've got that bit of backend logic that you can use to make a REST API or really do anything on your backend, you could pull from a blob store and get back some images that are stored in one of your stores, for example. Here I've got one image here. You could read from Edge config, where you can put your critical redirects for your application or other kind of structured JSON data. Or you could even go look at all the logs for your application. So here I have all of the requests that I've made to this /API/hello. So I see this 200 and I see some 304s here and I can see the exact request that I made, the runtime, the location, everything that happened inside of here. So you can get pretty detailed with the metrics that you want to see here as well too. If you do want to explore other frameworks that might have some backend functionality built in, on our templates page, we have a bunch of different frameworks listed here. You can even deploy Python functions to Vercel as well too. So maybe you want to use Flask or Django or some of these other things. We have a whole bunch of examples here. So in general, Vercel tries to make it as easy as possible for you to take code, whether it's functions that you've written or your front-end framework, and get it online as quickly as possible. All right, so that's how you can build your backend on Vercel by writing API functions or using some frameworks that allow you to integrate with your backend. If you want to see more videos going further in depth into writing standalone APIs or backends on Vercel, let me know and I can make more content here. Peace.